Things are gonna get real. I think. Maybe not until the spawning pit? I don't know. Not fair! Oh, crap. Back away. They're behind it. Ow. Oh, I could have shot that thing. For good measure. They're gonna pop out of stuff. Ooh, I hate them so much. Blech. Oh, they're too heavy or something? I couldn't really lift that one.
All targets down.
Yeah, for now. Crate. Heavy armor for human and assault rifle. Another Terminator 9. Whoops. I meant to go with that. How much Omni-Gel we have? Almost 1,000. I don't like the way they pop out like that. It's not fun for me. You guys got them? Thank you. This one? Now it gets fun. Oh! There's one this way. I see its frickin' feeler thingies. That didn't affect anything, did it? Did I hurt somebody? They just stand there, it's weird. Throw. Fine, just stand there and allow me to kill you. Okay. Well, finally, a grenade affects one of them. I'm not putting my gun away. I could pop out of crap at any time. Alright, let's go this one. Oh, you're big. Can I? I'm stuck. I'm what? What was I? In stasis? Is that what it was? We killed it? Is that like one of the queens or something?
Negative contact.
All right. I'm gonna end up using Omni-Gel. Shotgun, assault rifle. And medium armor for Turian. Another Storm 8. Banshee 9. Ooh, excuse me. And Garrus. Can you use any of these armors? Oh, definitely. That's medium. What are you using now? Details. Light armor, I guess. We gotta sell these armors. You're much better off now. Okay. Alright, so we destroyed it. We're good. Check the other tunnel. Well, there's the big boss one. Records of the Rachni War suggest brood warriors, the male-gendered Rachni, only fight when a hive is severely pressed. It's safe to say you've eliminated the Rachni on Nepmos. Cool. Well, you figured they might be all over the whole friggin' planet. That's good, though. Good to know.
Think we got him, Commander.
So these aren't queens, these are kings. Nope, I didn't see that one there. Another heavy armor for Krogan. Well, Krogan this time. Omni-tool. Alright. Oh, what am I doing? I'm the wrong thing. I forget what kind of, weapon we found. Let's check out his armor. Nope, not as good as the Titan 8 we just gave him. Better shields. Way better shields, but... Eh. Ooh, look at that. It's really just the ground. Okay, so we've checked that out, and that's it. Alright. So now we leave. Is this the way out? Or is that another tunnel? It's another tunnel. Good to hear we've destroyed all these freaking things. I didn't think we'd be fighting Rachni anymore. Oh, here's a crate. Pistol and sniper rifle. Stinger. Stinger 10. Get rid of these old 8s. I'll keep some of these. Oh, look at this Punisher. Much better. Oh, I almost omni-gelled it. Here we go. Can't go around there. Back behind all this crap, right? Is this a crate? Hello? Okay, we're headed the right way. Like, how the hell do I get out of here? We are done! Should we go visit our friends? Tell them what happened? I'm gonna go visit them. They'll be pretty happy. They're waiting to leave. So, like, why don't they leave before the things attack? They just want to kill them first? Area maps. Map updated. Was this even the debris? You know, I don't think it was. So let's head there. I think we just got distracted by this and thought this was debris. I don't know. Yeah, we haven't been there yet. Yeah, let's go up here. And then we'll go visit our friendly friends. We're on level terrain. Are you kidding me? Thank you. Damn it. Grenade upgrades. Ammo upgrades. Snowblind rounds. Okay, and grenades. Fusion, cryo, incendiary is another fusion. I'm guessing we got another fusion. I wasn't even really paying attention. Alright, off to our friends who are over here. And then we're done with this planet. We have another quest to do somewhere. I kinda wish we didn't, but we must explore it. Can we drive on that? I hope so, because we are driving on it. See how these guys are doing. Hopefully they're okay. They didn't get attacked while we were gone. They told us like 5 minutes or 3 minutes. And, oh, they're all still here. Cool. Jeez. It was the doors opening.
Join the Marines, see the galaxy. Hell.
Hell.
You're a hell of a soldier.
Well, you guys are done. We don't have an option to tell them.
There ain't any pirates here anyway.
Nope, and there's no Rachni here yet either anymore. Whatever the hell I was trying to say. Alright, we're done. So, yeah, back. We're done with this cluster. Where am I supposed to go now? Besieged base. Medical base on CHOHE in the Cacus System. Hades Gamma Cluster, okay. Let's just go there. Thank you. Now this must be another... A new, system added. What? I don't remember Plutus either. Cacus. I remember Farinata, that's for sure. Let's just check out what we have here. Hades Gamma. One of the first systems we explored. We went to Dis, Farinata, and Antaeus. Dis? Yeah, Plutus now. Farinata and Antaeus. So now we got Plutus and Cacus. Let's head to Cacus then. And we got another system to explore after this. But what I'm thinking is whatever quest we're doing now, which is with the biotic people, it might lead us to the other system, so might as well just take care of them first. Treyarmus planet. Treyarmus is a hydrogen-helium gas giant with a powerful magnetic field, making it a popular discharge site for freighters working the Anansi-Ishtar shipping route. It is popular enough, in fact, that Quarian ships can often be found loitering in orbit, selling the freighter crews cheap refreshments, salvage, and odd craftswork assembled by their children. There are no ships in orbit at present, however. Farangor. A large but low-density terrestrial world, Farangor is generally believed to consist mainly of water ice, occasional upwelling of metals, caused by the interacting tidal forces of several large moons, suggests the core is small but extremely dense. Farangor has a thin atmosphere of carbon dioxide and ethane. Its frozen surface is mainly composed of dark carbon-laced water ice. 10 years ago, Farangor's grim surface color and dim illumination drew the cinematographer Risa Uvarsson to film the exterior scenes of Starless on location. Acknowledged as a masterpiece of gothic horror, the sets, well preserved by the vacuum, draw hundreds of tourists to the backwater system every year. They shot a movie on this planet. That's pretty freaking cool, I think. We have revealed several small deposits of polonium. Zamari. CHOHE is what we're talking about. Going to. Zamari is a small, airless, cratered terrestrial, a lifeless rock quite similar to Luna. Its frozen surface is mainly composed of silicates, though one hemisphere has several seas of dark basaltic rock. And Zayarter. An enigmatic terrestrial planet, Zayarter has a hazy atmosphere of nitrogen and argon. The surface is scorching hot and mainly composed of calcium with deposits of sodium. Three times in the last century, ships stopping to discharge at Treyarmus have reported geometric patterns of lights on the dark side of Zayarter. Attempts at closer investigation prove fruitless. The lights disappear when ships move to approach the inner system. Scans have revealed a large deposit of mercury. And last, but certainly not least, CHOHE, if that's how you say it. CHOHE is a terrestrial planet whose surface is mainly composed of aluminum with numerous deposits of calcium. Though it has enough mass to maintain a dense atmosphere, CHOHE is nearly a vacuum. This lack of atmosphere allows a moderate average temperature, but the differences between day and night are extreme. The surface of CHOHE's sunward-facing side is usually covered by a haze of volatiles, mainly water vapor and carbon dioxide, which return to the ground as frost over the course of the long cold night. That's pretty cool. The CERTA Foundation has established a research outpost on CHOHE to investigate the native subterranean life of CHOHE, which shows incredible resilience to extremes of heat and cold. Okay. Gravity is identical to that of Earth, at least. There goes that combat planet theme. Okay, we got debris, science base, anomalous signal right here. More like right here. This way. It's pretty close to us, at least. I'll never get over how this thing handles. It's like crazy. Hello. Fuel tank. Locked crate. Pistol and amp and heavy armor, which I don't use. While sifting through this pile of debris, you discovered another of Matriarch Dilanaga's writings. It's in bad shape, but most of it's still intact. Okay, bonus one.
Ready whenever you are.
Then you're ready now, lady. Deactivate. Close to the transmitter, your comms pick up a recording of a wistful string quartet. You power the system down. Whoever lived here, they haven't been back for some time. The crates are covered with CHOHE's chalky dust, and the status lights of the shack indicate its atmosphere ran out long ago. Okay, so they were playing radio stations. Weapon upgrade, grenade upgrade. It looks like someone has been living in this place. The small crate held some stale food and one of Matriarch Dilanaga's writings. It's still in fairly good condition, unlike the food. Yeah, we're finding a lot of these writings. Weapon upgrades, ammo. It is not clear who owns this container, but you discovered one of Matriarch Dilanaga's writings. It's inside. My god, all over the friggin' place. We've already found all the ones we need. So funny. Anything with this probe? We can't walk. Okay. Alright, let's go through this really quickly. Frictionless materials. 8. Is old. An old kinetic coil. Extra snowblown rounds. And grenade stuff. Okay. Okay, continuing. We'll go to the debris next. Wouldn't be surprised if we come across something else along the way. Don't know how many of these people I'm going to have to kill, and we have to make sure not to kill the biotic people. That's who we were sent on this mission, because we were smart. Not bumbling idiots who just shoot anyone who moves. Watch me regret those words. Whee! Nice flat surface. Really don't have enough flat surfaces in this galaxy. making good time here. Whee! Is it whatever this is? Crash probe.
I'm on my way.
Well, so am I. Always with the ammo upgrades and grenade upgrades, huh? High explosive. And grenade upgrades. Oh, well, look at that. High explosive 9, okay. Better. Since I used grenades recently, I don't use them very often. Okay, off to the science base, which is probably our final destination. Yay, flat ground. It's interesting looking. Oh, there's a mineral over here. Let's check it out. And we don't have to climb a mountain to get it. We might have to do that to get to the research base. You know, it says that because we're moving, but it thinks we're not on level terrain. It's still saying that we can't... Wait. That was weird. A large deposit of mercury. Can't get in the Mako.
You lead. I'll follow.
Wasn't trying to talk to you. Continuing. Getting really close. Oh, I see it. You have to fight anyone outside? Okay, I'm guessing we just go in here. Take down the terrorists, but remember to check your targets. The civilians are so addled by the drug, they'll wander right in the middle of a firefight.